When you're poor, it can be hard to go grab a cheeseburger or buy the newest video game, but that's not the worst part about it. The tough part is that even if you get rich, the effects of poverty stick with you. Hey everyone, thank you for watching DNews Today. I'm Trace. As of 2011, the World Bank estimates 17% of people lived at or below $1.25 a day. That's just over a billion people. In 1981, it was closer to 2 billion, so we are making progress. In 2013, the official poverty rate in the US was 14.5%, totaling around 45.3 million poor people in the wealthiest country in the world. Governments worldwide are fighting poverty in a number of ways, and not just because it's the right thing to do. Science says poverty actually harms you. A 2013 study published in Science explored how poverty impairs overall cognitive function. They looked at farmers, both pre- and post-harvest, of a cash crop of sugarcane. After the harvest of the cane, nutrition wasn't immediately improved, but that influx of cash gave the farmers financial security. That security gave their cognitive performance a boost. Post-harvest farmers were able to make better decisions than pre-harvest farmers had. Poverty is a combination of stressors, which as a whole are not fully understood by science. The findings in the journal Science suggest stress alone doesn't explain all of poverty's effects on humankind, and that being in poverty keeps the brain from processing information properly. But how those effects manifest seem to vary. For example, a study released last month in Nature Neuroscience found a link between physical brain development and poverty level. In a study of the brain images of nearly 1,100 children, adolescents, and young adults from around the US, researchers found significant differences in the brains of children of the lowest income bracket in comparison to those in the highest, even when controlling for ethnic background. Families who lived on less than $25,000 a year had as much as 6% less surface area in their brain in areas like language and decision making than families who made more than $150,000 a year. Poverty's effects on the brain cause excess stress in children, both psychologically and physiologically. Poor children can suffer from substandard housing, homelessness, inadequate childcare, under-resourced schooling, and of course, inadequate nutrition. All of these can then cause stress, leading to anxiety, depression, and low self-esteem, as well as a tendency toward violence. In a study of 44 African-American infant girls, brains of those from poorer families were smaller than those of wealthier families. Even at only 1 month old, the effects of poverty can be seen on those physical structures of the human brain. Extreme poverty is a real hardship, affecting people even after they've risen above the poverty line. Familial stressors like family disruption, financial stress, and maternal poor health can cause obesity in children, which isn't easy to overcome. Plus, anxiety, low self-esteem, and differing brain structures all require future attention from healthcare to fix, which could be avoided by raising children and families out of poverty. In families with a low socioeconomic status, shifts of even a few thousand dollars of extra family income was visible in brain structures. Governments around the world are working hard to find solutions to these problems. In the US, our poverty solutions involve giving tax breaks, food stamps, and social security programs to poor individuals. Though many politicians scoff at these ideas, the poverty rate has declined. One recent study conducted in Kenya showed that when poor people are simply given money, they tend to spend it on education, healthcare, and housing improvements, all of which decrease the poverty stress on them and their children. Not to say the problem is solved by any means, research is ongoing, but this episode of DNews is just one part of the story. For the full picture, you should watch Test Tube to learn if these policies, like food stamps, actually work to raise people out of poverty.
This year, a single person with no children would need to make less than $973 a month to qualify. For a four-person household, that number increases to $1,988 or less.
Also, you can ask us any science questions you may have down in the comments. Maybe you've been on food stamps before. Why don't you tell us about your experience? Thanks for watching DNews. Please subscribe.